This is the application for the Tempest Weather Station. Starting here at the top, in the left, you see the name of your Tempest Station, in my case, Wander 001 Tempest Station. You can select the down arrow, and if you had multiple Tempest Stations, you can actually select it from your list there. Over here on the right, that is your actual Tempest Station. We'll talk about that in a moment, because right here, you are seeing weather data, and that weather data is after your information has been sucked out of your weather station and sent and processed through their AI. So this is giving you a AI massaged weather reading for your location. So right here you can see for my current filming time, it is 46 degrees, it feels like 46, 56 relative humidity, the barometric pressure is dropping in hectopascals, it is cloudy, you see that there is a slight breeze from the east southeast at 2 miles an hour, and you might see that kind of raise up a little bit as we go around talking. Here it is UV index, or UV is at zero. That's because I'm currently filming this when it is dark out. You have your actual weather. So right now it is today, rain likely, 100% chance of rain currently. 32 degrees is the low, 52 degrees is the high. I wish they did have these reversed where I would see the high first and then the low, but that's a personal preference. And then we have sunrise and sunset, and then we can scroll throughout the day and see what our weather is going to be like. And that's going to show you, is it raining? Is it partly cloudy? Temperature, percent chance, and then what direction the wind is coming from. So that's really cool. And then if you scroll down here, you kind of get that outlook going for several days. And if I open any one of these, it will show me exactly what's going on. And that's gonna, again, be going through the AI. And if I wanted to close that, I simply tap again. Down here at the bottom, we have three options. First being weather, which brings us to this screen. So if you're somewhere else, it brings you back to our main home screen. You have your history, and then your history has several different things that you can kind of look up. You've got day, week, month, year, and then all time. So if I did the week, it will show me air temperature, min, max, and average, relative humidity, again, min, max, average, sea level pressure, lightning strikes, so I haven't had any lightning strikes recently, wind, so min, max, and then average, and it even tells you what direction it came from, rain, haven't had any rain recently, again, within the last week that this is doing, UV index, so minimum of 0, maximum of 4.2, and then average of 0.7, solar radiation, brightness and lux, I mean, there's a lot that you can pull out of your history. Last is actually our settings, but we can get to our settings from another location as well. So we're gonna come back to our main area. And I'm coming back to the main area because, again, I kept stating this goes through the AI. However, if we come up here and select the icon that looks like a Tempest Station, like you have, it's actually going to be the raw data from your actual Tempest Station before it's processed by the AI. So here you can see temperature, dew point, humidity, barometric pressure, and showing trending falling. Here you can actually see lightning strike. I had one day ago. It was 24 to 26 miles away, and it last was 3 hours ago. I will say this is really cool in that I'll flash up on the screen. When you do get a lightning strike warning, you'll see that lights up as yellow. It's really cool. Here you have your wind speed. So your actual current wind speed within the last 2 to 3 minutes, and then any gusts that you have. UV, again, I'm doing this at night, won't see anything there, but you've got your brightness level and your solar radiation, which is very nice, and you're watching my winds switch around as the wind continues to blow. Currently, I have no rainfall, and one thing I will state about this little icon right here with the check mark next to your little raindrop there, that indicates that it's taking an average of your weather stations in your vicinity. That's not giving you an actual raw level for your particular station. I had a friend of mine who was asking me about that because he picked one up too, and that's what he found out and relayed that information on to me because he wants exact measurements for his location. There is a way to turn that off. I'll throw it down in the description area below. That icon would be raining if it was actually raining. Here you have your battery voltage. It states good. And then down here we have information based on my particular station. So station pressure, dew point, wet bulb temperature, delta T, air density, rain duration today, and rain duration yesterday. You can get very nerdy about all of your stats here. One of the things I really like about the application, hypothetically, let's say you don't particularly care about your last lightning strike. Well, if you click and hold, you can drag this down and place it wherever you want. So you can actually move things that you find more important. So let's say I always want to know about this and this first. Maybe then I want to know about UV, and we'll put barometric pressure above lightning. So rain will always be last, but these are the things that I want to see in this order. So you can move things around. Now, the app itself is for both Android and iOS, but the website will closely mirror what you're looking at here. One thing that's different than the history that you have down here is if I select any one of these icons, I will get a history, a running tally for that particular thing. So here we can see, and this is a little easier to see on a computer, so this part I will admit, I'll come in here. Here's our history for our temperatures. And if you like data and raw data and analytical stuff, clicking into any one of these, you're going to get a lot of data. And it's really great that they give you that information. Now, I did say that the settings option right down here, you can access it from other locations. Mainly, that's because I wanted to show you this first. Clicking on our settings in the lower right will bring us to, well, the email address you have this registered to. You have sign out. You have station, so here's your manage. I can click on station, and then again, I can add another station, or if I wanted to, I can change the name, location, as well as I can set this to be private or a non-private station. Currently, I have my station private, so you won't see it on the global map, but you can do all of that from stations. Smart home integration, well, currently I have it tied up with Alexa, which is rather nice, so you can ask it, what's the weather or what's the temperature? It will give you an exact readout for your location. That's why you're getting a weather station, so that you have that exact hyperlocal readout. Temperature, selecting that, Fahrenheit or Celsius. Pressure, you have hectopascals, millimeters of mercury, inches of mercury, and millibar. You can select what you would prefer. Wind speed, lots of choices there. Miles per hour, knots, kilometers per hour, meters per second, not even gonna try, etc. Wind direction, cardinal or degrees. So swapping that, if we come back, you'll now see it says a degree rather than north, south, east, or west. Rain, inches, millimeter, or centimeters. Distance, imperial or metric, other, imperial or metric. Alerts, so these are cool. You can have rain starts, lightning, status, selecting on or off, depending on what you want. Quality control, on or off. The rain and lightning ones are the really interesting ones. You might not think, hey, I need to know about when it starts to rain. Well, if you're like me and you film and you don't have any windows, then it's really useful knowing when there's actual rain. Likewise with a lightning strike, if you set this up with IFTTT, you can actually have a lightning strike be detected here, and then all of your lights in your house might flash or change a different color to let you know, hey, there was a lightning strike. Do I need to do this? Do I need to shut down my computers? Maybe I have to bring the kids from outside in the backyard. These are really cool. I thought I wouldn't enjoy them as much as I have, but I really do like them. And then here we have our display mode, which is always on mode. I have that off. You have full screen mode, meaning you wouldn't see the bumpers, which I'm hiding in my film here. And under more, you've got help, Tempest Map, and other Weatherflow apps. If you're looking at this via the web, this will look a lot better. But if you come into the Tempest Map, it's gonna show you, hey, here's all the weather stations. So if I kind of pinch and zoom, so if I'll come in here, as you can see, until you start getting really close, it's gonna be tricky to see. Try and do it for here. Every one of those blue dots is a weather station that somebody has shared. So if I come over, and I want a weather station for Lancaster. Well, here we go. I select this one, and it's gonna give me the readout of exactly for that location. And this is also why you wanna be careful of your naming convention. You don't wanna call it, hey, this is my name, come check out my weather station, because you are giving coordinates kinda to where you're located, which is also why I'll be changing the name of my weather station after this goes up. But that's one of the cool features of the Tempest ecosystem, is people's willingness to share their data, and it will give you hyperlocal data for that location. Because sometimes, let's be honest, data you get, not the greatest. This app, the fact that it's an app and not actually some other peripheral that you have to have in your house, makes it even better, because my wife has it on her phone, I have it on my phone, we always know what the weather is. It's great. That was a look at the app for the Tempest weather station and everything that it can do.